What's up guys, it's your boy Milano Miguel, back at it again with another video. Today is episode 35 of the AC Milan blog series, so here we go.
To help us, Dragowski. Well done, young man. That was grass in the morning. Now don't go hear me try to shake my hand, I'm a home.
Match day 35 in the Italian Serie A, which will take place with Sassuolo versus Milan. The last time Milan and Sassuolo took on, it was the 120th anniversary of Milan, which was a stalemate for Sassuolo and Milan. Milan almost scored with Rafael Leao hitting the post, but it wasn't enough. Sassuolo versus Milan is also very special because Donnarumma is making his 200th appearance for the Rosonerri, so that is great for him. Donnarumma, Conti, Kjaer, Romagnoli, Theo Hernandez, Kessier, Benacer, Rebic, Hakan Çalhanoğlu, Alexis Salamakers, and Zlatan Ibrahimovic. Now, I would say the start of the game was really slow. We seemed a bit sluggish. Our movement was a bit off. It seemed like we're a bit fatigued. We just needed to get our heads in the game and figure out what was going on. A lot of players were slipping and sliding around. We didn't really retain possession in the first couple of minutes of the game, but that's how the game started for us. With that slow start to the game, Andrea Conti would come off in the 10th minute with an injury. It really sucks to see Conti come off in the 10th minute. He's been struggling with injuries previously over the years, and he's finally got himself into the side, and now he came off with another injury. He was replaced by Davide Calabria. Berardi would have an opportunity to score in the 13th minute for Sassuolo, but it would go straight into the hands of Donnarumma. Zlatan Ibrahimovic has been doing all the dirty work for Milan. He makes defenders come at him because they know he's a talisman, he's a target. He's doing that dirty work for Milan to find opportunities to score, which is very great. Zlatan Ibrahimovic would break the deadlock in the 19th minute, coming from across from Hakan Çalhanoğlu. Beautiful header from Zlatan. Milan would almost score again in the 23rd minute, coming off of a corner kick, but nobody was at the back post to put it in. Romagnoli was there but wasn't able to get a foot onto it. Benacer would provide Ibra with another opportunity, a beautiful cross, but that header would go straight into Consigli's arms. And then the game took a drastic turn. Milan were settling, Milan were dominating, and in the 32nd minute, Romagnoli seems like he pulled something in his calf and just came off immediately. He was replaced by Mattia Gabbia, and Gianluigi Donnarumma would take the captain's armband. In the 40th minute, Sassuolo would have a free kick in which there was a cross put in. Hakan Çalhanoğlu, Varcek, handball, deemed as a penalty. Caputo steps up, slots it home in the 42nd minute. Milan 1, Sassuolo 1. Just when it seemed like the game was getting out of hand and things were getting worse and worse progressively after injuries and the handball, Zlatan Ibrahimovic and Hakan Çalhanoğlu would find each other again. A great pass from Hakan Çalhanoğlu, getting another assist for Zlatan Ibrahimovic, scoring in the 46th minute for Milan, giving Milan a 2-1 lead. Then shortly after that, Burabia would be sent off of a rash tackle because he was already on a yellow card. Rash tackle, unnecessary tackle on Rebic, gets a red card right before the final whistle, and that is how halftime ended. So after the half, Theo Hernandez would come off to be replaced by Diego Lechao, which somewhat makes sense because Hernandez got suspended for having a yellow card, and Lechao would get about a half of playing time to get, you know, his legs under him. But I also think that it didn't really make any sense because Theo Hernandez already got his suspension and Benacer was the next one who is most likely to be risked for suspension. But either way, Ibrahimovic would look to try and bag his hat trick, but Consigli would just not go for it, neither would Sassuolo. Although Ibrahimovic tried to no avail, he could not find his hat trick. He had this really one great opportunity, beautiful pass from Kessié, 1-2, but he just lost his footing and his first touch was too much on the ball. Benacer would hit the post in the 74th minute, who also will be suspended against Atalanta. Atalanta on Friday, including Theo Hernandez. Hakan Çalhanoğlu and Ismail Benacer would come off to be replaced by Giacomo Bonaventura and Lucas Biglia. Very good game for Hakan Çalhanoğlu. Hakan had 2 assists in this game. He's been racking up assists since the restart. Really improved his quality, his passing, his crossing, his service, the vision that he's been having to create opportunities for his teammates and for this Milan side has been outstanding. This is the quality of a player that we knew that we were getting when we bought him for Bayer Leverkusen, but we haven't seen that yet. So it's really great and amazing to see that he's showing that. I don't know what Pioli did to bring that confidence or bring this performance out of him, but Hakan Çalhanoğlu, really great performance. Keep it up. Konchikli had a huge save in the 80th minute. Giacomo Bonaventura was looking to just hit one home off a rebound, and Konchikli made 3 back-to-back saves. Just absolutely amazing. Clearly, I think he's Sassuolo's man of the match for their team. But nevertheless, Milan would win 2-1 away from home at Sassuolo Stadium. The 2 goals coming from Zlatan Ibrahimovic and 2 assists from Hakan Çalhanoğlu. This is Milan's 10th game undefeated since the restart of football and action. Really, really great to see that even though we had adversity, we had those injuries, we had some suspensions that were made, we kept fighting, we kept trying to look for that third goal. I really think this was a great game. My man of the match has to be between Hakan Çalhanoğlu and also Zlatan Ibrahimovic. Zlatan got the 2 goals, but Hakan also provided the service. Without the service, there are no goals, so you vote. Actually, yeah, vote up above to see who is your man of the match. Do you prefer Hakan or Zlatan Ibrahimovic? Nevertheless, a very much needed 3 points that puts us into 59 points at the table. We move ahead Roma and Napoli, who are still yet to play. We have Atalanta on Friday, which is going to be a huge game. No Benacer, no Theo Hernandez. I think Diego Lechaut can do a decent job. He did a decent job in the Sassuolo game, replacing Hernandez, so I think that's gonna be okay. But missing Benacer is really what I'm more worried about. So during the game, some very great, massive breaking news broke out. There was a report from German news media outlets that Ragnik to Milan was off when Ragnik to Milan had been confirmed about a couple of weeks ago. It has been confirmed that Ragnik will no longer be coming to Milan. Pioli will be manager of Milan until 2022, confirmed by AC Milan themselves after the game. That's really what I'm gonna say for now. There is no right or wrong answer in my opinion, but if you guys would like for me to make a video going more in depth about this situation, my thoughts and what I think, comment below for me. But that's really all I have for you guys. Forza Milan. Peace.